Hi, this is Priyanka and you're watching the Rooster News. We are here to talk about NEET. Do you think it's a fair examination? And why do you think there are children, students dying because of NEET? It was only yesterday I was sitting with my friends and talking about the NEET results. The more and more I spoke about it, the more and more questions arise which had no answer at all. The one particular thing that really disturbed my mind was the newspaper headline about the tragic death, a suicide of a student. I guess when the marks are out, the student feels the pressures of the society, the pressures of the family, and can probably visualize the shattering of dreams, the career, the future, and their lives. Now, this scenario has raised so many questions which has to be answered at the earliest. The first question is, why do you think the pattern of marks is so extreme? Well, let me answer it for you. The CBSE conducts the examination and the question paper is set by the Medical Council of India. It takes into consideration the syllabus of CBSE, IB, IGSE, ICSE and the state board. Now, there are two points to it. A, the state board syllabus is different all over the states of India. Hence, there is no standardization, no proper curriculum, whereas the other boards enjoy that standardization, a pattern. The second point is, have you ever wondered when a child scores 98% in his state board examination, whereas can't score the bare minimum to qualify for NEET exams? Why? The reason here is that it is time that state board syllabus needs to be upgraded, has to be strengthened, made at par with the other boards, and has to be regularized, has to be standardized across all over India. The second question is, why suicide? Life is so precious. If one opportunity goes, there is another one that will come by. This is not the end of the world. Why can't the parents, why can't the society tell this to their children? Is it because they are imposing their dreams, their ambitions on their children? Think about it. Trust me, there are parents who have withdrawn their children from school and have admitted them into mock schools. So the child as young as 11 years, 12 years, he is getting trained for competitive exam at the cost of his childhood. Well, imagine the kind of stress, the pressure on the child, all because the parents want the youngest doctors, the youngest engineers in their families. In my opinion, it is time to introduce counselors in schools, or in particular for NEET aspirants. And the most important thing, it's time for parents to be the support of their children, to let them know no matter what, they will stand by them. The third question is, why this pressure? Well, let me break the answer into three different points for you. Out of the 14.19 lakh students who had appeared for the exam, 7.97 lakh students cleared the exam. Now, clearing the exam is one thing and getting a seat is a completely different thing. First of all, there are hardly 70,000 seats available, which includes the government, colleges, private colleges and other deemed universities. So, the demand and supply, the gap is so big that it would take time for bridging this problem, to bridge this gap. Secondly, the quota system. So, your marks and your category has to be aligned with which reservation quota you belong, and that's when you will be able to get your seat. The third point is, everybody is competing for the government seat, simply because the private colleges' fees is exorbitantly high. So all these points have created such big pressure on the students that it becomes really difficult for them to handle it. What is your opinion? Do you think that this pressure is justified? The last question is extremely thought-provocative. Is every child given an equal platform? Well, let us look at it on a wider spectrum. There is no standardization of state board syllabus. There's someone in the north studying different things. There's someone in south studying different things. Secondly, increasing commercialization of the coaching centers. Thirdly, the exorbitant fees the private medical colleges are charging. Thirdly, the dependency on reservation quota instead of the student's own caliber. See, all these points are somewhere there in the system which needs to be checked on an immediate basis. Please leave us your thoughts and suggestions in the comment box down. Thank you.